In this video, I will go over the different steps that you need to follow when you want to perform a whole genome SNP analysis in your BioNumerics database. First, you need to import your sequence reads in your database and store them in a sequence read set experiment. Sequence reads can be imported as data links in your BioNumerics database, resulting in a lightweight database. Sequence reads can also be stored inside the connected database, but this might fill up your database very quickly. Next, a reference sequence needs to be selected. The choice of a reference sequence in a whole genome SNP analysis is very important since only genomic information that is in common between the reference sequence and the sample sequences will be included in the analysis. This means that the reference should be as similar as possible to the sample sequences. In the next step, the reads are mapped against the reference sequence, assuring that all genomic sequences are in the same frame and have the same length, which is an important prerequisite when you want to do a SNP analysis. Mapping the reads can be done locally or using the external calculation engine. In the actual SNP analysis, the sample sequences obtained in the previous mapping step are compared to the reference sequence and the base differences are recorded. Not all recorded SNPs are relevant. Some might, for example, be caused by sequencing errors or rearrangements. In BioNumerics, various SNP filters are available to retain only the relevant high-quality SNPs. The SNP matrix containing those SNPs that are retained by the applied filters can be further analyzed in the comparison window. A whole genome SNP clustering can be initiated on the SNP matrix using a wide range of clustering options.